สวัสดีครับ Greeting from Bangkok Once again Kasit Piromya. This time I will comment a bit or give my point of view about the current move by members of the Senate, the upper house of the Thai Parliament, to introduce a no confidence motion on the Thai government under the leadership of Prime Minister Setha Tawisin. I find that very strange and quite unnecessary and inappropriate indeed. Because the majority of the members of the Senate was the one that voted for the premiership candidacy of Mr. Setha Tawisin a few months ago. So Prime Minister Setha Tawisin is like a brainchild or a product of the Senate. Prime Minister Setha Tawisin can be considered, from my point of view, as one of their own, one of the makings of the senators. And now, why should they come out with the idea of introducing a censure motion or no confidence vote on the government of Thailand under the leadership of Prime Minister Setha Tawisin? It doesn't seem to be logical at all. Because throughout the months and so on, they could have invited the Prime Minister and some members of the Cabinet to the Senate to exchange views, pose questions and all of this and so on. And so far, there has not been any news about the perception of the senators that the government of Thailand under the leadership of Prime Minister Setha Tawisin has done something drastically wrong in the conduct of the affairs of government and so on. So why no confidence vote at this point in time? There have not been any news about the raison d'etre or the reason behind the request for a no confidence debate inside the upper house or the Senate. What are the grievances? What are the causes? What are the discontentments and so on? So in that sense, I feel that there must have been some sort of a hidden motive. And I'm somewhat a bit reluctant and ashamed to be negative in my perception that the whole exercise of the move for a censure motion or no confidence debate in the upper house or in the Senate is for some senators the chance to make a name of themselves before that tenure comes to an end in the month of May of this year. So it's more or less an exercise from my point of view to perpetuate self-esteem, popularity, possibly at the expense of the Prime Minister and his cabinet members and so on. Or even for some of them to lay the foundation for their eventual political activities in other clothings, in other hats and so on. From my point of view, for the past few months and so on, members of the Senate or the Senate as a whole could be partners, friends, or even chaperones for the Prime Minister in the running of the country for the benefit of the Thai people. So why keep all the ideas only for the confidence, no confidence debate, which could take place maybe in the course of the month of March or April? Why not say it now? What you would like to say to the Prime Minister and his cabinet, and what you would like to tell the Thai public in general about the performances of the Thai government under the leadership of Mr. Setha Tewisin, the Thai Prime Minister. And in other words, it's also a diversion of the public interest towards other things which are much more urgent, or even to deter somewhat the efforts on the part of the government to move the country forward, because members of the government, the cabinet members, would have to spend time studying the subject matters and prepare for the debate or to explain what has been going on in their respective areas of responsibilities. And this type of no confidence votes is only a debating exercise, as the Senate cannot vote to oust the government. So it will become more of an intellectual exercise, or maybe an what you call exercise in boredom and so on, without any of the positive effects to come out of the debate and so on. And the Thai public would definitely would not gain anything. It would be too late anyway for the Senate to come and say something in the last minute before their eventual demise and departure from the political scene. So let's remain positive. And we are still in the midst of the month of February. And if I were to give the senators, each one of them, 3-4 weeks to do their homework and tell the public what do they think about the performances of the cabinet members and the government as a whole? What are their recommendations? What are their views on the amendments to the Constitution, on the reforms of the military establishment, on the reform of the judicial procedures, on the enhancement of public participation in the affairs of the state, both at the national and at the local level? What are their ideas about decentralization of Thailand? What are their ideas about further trends of the industrialization of Thailand? What would be the economic development direction of Thailand? and so on. All of these could have been forthcoming from the Senate and member of the Senate as a whole. One doesn't have to wait for the no confidence debate to take place. Every day from now on, the senators can talk to the public, or they can have a much more open debate among themselves inside the Senate and be televised and let the public know about their great ideas and great vision for the country, and not to play politics or to be active only on the 1 or 2 days of the censure motion or the debate, the no confidence debate. Let them do the work for the public on a day-to-day basis. My only message to them is, for each of the senators, tell us the good news. Tell us your vision. Tell us what are the recommendations that you would like to give to the government at this point in time. Commit yourself to lofty ideas and to the vision for the future of Thailand as a decent democratic entity. Thank you very much. ขอบคุณมากครับ